Today we are going to have a special guest who used to be a student in New Zealand, and now she's here. Could you please introduce yourself?
Hi, my name is P.Jah or nickname Jah. I'm currently working as an associate consultant for learning resources and working for family businesses. CPB Educational Innovation Consultant and Sun Group Management. I just graduated from College of Management, McGill University, majoring in innovation and management. And also, I did my bachelor degree in New Zealand for Bachelor of Commerce and Administration, majoring in marketing and psychology. I also did my high school in Wellington, New Zealand as well.
Okay, so this session is going to be very special for the students who would like to study in New Zealand. Okay, for the first question, could you please explain about New Zealand educational system?
Well, for the high school years, we started from year 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13, so there are 5 years of high school. The junior years are the year 9 and year 10, but then when you go up to year 11, you become a senior, so year 11, 12, and 13. But year 13 is special. Say that it's more like of a preparation year before you enter university in New Zealand. So say if you are from Thailand, you did your high school years in New Zealand, can do up to year 12 and then come back and do university back in Thailand. So it's a special kind of system.
I heard about the state school and private school. Could you please explain more?
The state school is like a public school. The city is
supported by government.
Yeah.
Right.
And mostly the state schools are top school in that particular town. But private school has their strength because they are financially funded by an organization and the facility is better. But that also depends on each town as well, because for my city, for Wellington, the school that I went to, Wellington Girls College, is ranked number one in the city, even though it's a public school.
Mm-hmm.
And most schools in New Zealand are either a boy or a girl school. Not many are co-ed school, co-ed education.
Okay.
So that's an advantage. They say that so that the students can concentrate on study.
Okay.
Not being distracted by anything else.
And do you think so?
I think so. Well, we enjoy, friends are friends. Everyone enjoys the company of each other.
Okay. Okay, for the course, I would like to know how do you study by choosing the course or subject that you are interested in?
Start from the younger years. The school set a certain compulsory courses. For example, English, Maths, Science, Physical Education. These are the compulsory courses. But as
and every student must study.
Yeah, but the students also get to choose their interested courses. For example, if they like doing art, they can do painting art, or they can do textile, cutting, sewing, designing clothes. That's a good way. But as you get older, you can choose any course that you like. So at the end, you'll have total control of your study plan.
And how do you think they would be good for higher education?
Well, you can discover what you like and what you don't like since high school. You don't have to waste your time and wait until you're in university and find out
what
you like and don't like.
Okay.
Yeah. that saves a lot of time. And for some courses, you might not want to be studying in that course for the rest of your life. I mean, not be involved in that course. But for example, if I want to know about basic knowledge about economics, I can do that in high school for 1 year, and then the next year I might not have to do it anymore. But it depends. It's very flexible.
Same as you choose psychology.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. And for my school, in my year 13, the school offers me to go and take courses in university. The first year university course, even though I was in year 13. So that's an advancement that I could do for my study.
Okay. For the advantages studying in New Zealand?
Well, first thing I have to say that it's safe. I can come out
at night
and it will still be safe. I wake up say 7, 6, 7 and walk to school, it will still be safe. And I don't have to worry about people stealing stuff.
Okay.
And I'm not like Bangkok sometimes, you know, when you finish school, once you finish your extracurricular activities, you go home, you'll be worrying.
Okay,
lots.
It's not gonna happen to you.
Well, my parents at that time, they didn't worry about me at all.
Okay.
They would occasionally call and ask how I was doing. But say if I was in Thailand, they would call every day and ask where I was.
Okay. Is that because the city is not that busy as in Bangkok?
That's right? One of the main reasons. But the people there are very friendly. You get a lot of people from different places in the world. It's very diverse. Culturally, diversity is like the main thing in Wellington. So you get to know a lot of people. I can say that I know people from almost every country now.
Wow. Okay.
Most Asian countries.
Most Asian.
I have a friend from Kazakhstan. Uh-huh. I have a friend from Somalia. Every country in Asia is a friend from Polynesian Islands, the one you have never heard of before. Those friends are there.
It's cross-cultural.
Very.
What about the difference between Thai and New Zealand education, and what is the advantage for studying in New Zealand?
In New Zealand, I would say that the education system has a very good standard throughout New Zealand, throughout nationwide. Each school has a small difference,
okay,
but mostly a very good school. We have this thing called New Zealand National Certificate of Educational Achievement, which is the standard that every school uses, and it assesses students' performance, academic performance. Sometimes, when you're in your high school years, your senior high school years, there are three levels, NCEA level 1, 2, and 3. You can, if you're very good at maths, you can do, even though you're in year 12, you can do year 13 maths. So you can do an advanced course. Or say if you're not so good at a language, a third language, say Chinese, you can do a less advanced course as well. Even though you're in year 12, you can do a year 11 course. So that's a good thing. So you can it's multi-level classes.
So it's like customized.
Yes.
Skill.
Yes.
Uh-huh. That's good.
And you start to choose the subjects that you like in high school. Say if you know from the beginning that you want to be a photographer, you can choose to do a photography class in high school. You don't have to wait until you enter university. I did my psychology classes since year 12, and I knew then that I liked it. so I want to continue my study in this area.
This one is quite different from Taipei. Talking about the university, could you please explain about the requirement of the university?
Well, the compulsory education for New Zealand is actually up to year 12. So once you complete year 12, you are free to go. You're not bound by the state to do year 13. But if you want to enter university, you have to complete year 13.
Year 12 is equivalent to Matayong 6.
That's right. Year 12 is equivalent to Matayong 6. So year 13 is more like a pre-university year. If I was in, oh, when I was in New Zealand, I had to do year 13 because I planned to go to university in New Zealand. But for those who wanted to come back to Thailand, my friends, once they finished year 12, they came back to Thailand and could enter a university in Thailand straight away. On the other hand, I have friends from Thailand who completed their Matayong 6 in Thailand, and then they can go straight into a university in New Zealand. And for a bachelor degree, it only takes 3 years to complete.
So,
so instead of doing a 4-year degree in Thailand or say in the United States, you save 1 year.
Charter.
Or a full year.
What about scholarship?
The scholarship, well, if you are from Thailand, if you complete your high school in Thailand and want to go to university in New Zealand, there's a scholarship offered for international students. Or in my case, when I was in high school, I applied for a scholarship. Unfortunately, I didn't get it.
It's okay.
But mostly they offer scholarships for either academically excellent students or very financially hardship, they call. But those who struggle to find tuition fees because they don't have financial support from their family or background. Another type of scholarship is for those who contribute to the society, the leadership kind of scholarship.
So there, every scholarship, the candidate needs to have the evidence.
That's right. At least the grades.
Financial statement
and English proficiency test to make sure that they are able to complete their study in New Zealand.
I think this is very good comment and feedback from the students who used to study in New Zealand. Okay, I think for the students who are interested in New Zealand, who very change your mind and thinking New Zealand as one of your choice. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.